जाएं टू स्पीक ऑन आर्थ्रोस्कोपिक कोरोबोरेशन ऑफ क्लिनिकली डिमॉन्स्ट्रेटेड रिस्ट पैथोलॉजी. कैन यू शेयर योर प्रेजेंटेशन प्लीज?
कैन यू सी इट नाउ?
यस सर. या
ओके. Now, speaking about the arthroscopic corroboration of the lot of wrist pathologies which was described by Anil sir, but I would like to show some of the commonest one which you see. So, my job is like basically a Google map. I need to tell you various bird's eye view on various conditions, like how to reach there and how does it look. So, few conditions, namely like TFCC tears, which you commonly come across, synovitis, contour lesions, traumatic ones, the ligament injuries like scapulonate or lunate equatorial injuries, and ganglion, volar and dorsal ganglion as well. Then you see scaphoid non-unions, ulnar impaction, ulnar styloid impingement, although it's rare, but it can be seen, it's there, keen box, etc. These are few conditions which I will be trying to share you. This is a TFCC tear where basically you are visualizing from the 3-4 portal and you are checking for the trampoline effect which Dr. Anil was talking about. So this, the various classification on this, but I am just showing this one of them which is on the radial side there, and you can see the ulnar head through the tear. So the loss of trampoline effect is an identifying point or a technique to pick up whether the TFCC is torn. This is on the radial side. Similarly, you can have tear further on the... There's another dorsal, this is another image where you have a dorsal capsular tear as well. Like you are feeling from the, you are viewing from the 3-4 portal, but you're palpating from the 6R portal, that's a TFCC. You're checking for the trampoline effect. That's a large tear which you can see in the upper part of the column, and this part you're seeing, that's a large tear on the dorsal capsular tear which you can see. So similarly, you can see this is another foveal insertion tear where you can this is on the foveal side where you have the tear. You can see the tear on the ulnar side, and by you're trying to hook. This is a hook test which you are trying to demonstrate the TFCC there. So you can easily do a lift off there on the ulnar side. So this was on the TFCC. There are other conditions like synovitis, which is quite useful in case of tuberculosis or in case of rheumatoid arthritis as well in earlier stage, or maybe even after 6 months of medical treatment, if the symptoms are not abating, arthroscopic synovectomy quite helps quite a lot. And we'll be surprised that X-ray sometimes appears a lot of arthritis will be seen on the, or the derangement you can see on an X-ray. But when you come, when you visualize the arthroscope, the cartilage, like for example, this one, the X-ray showed a lot of derangement, but the cartilage was quite good. And synovitis, for some reason, they tend to be more effect on the volar capsule and on the ulnar side as well. So this is a quite a useful tool in, when we are looking in case of synovitis, either tuberculosis or rheumatoid arthritis. The another indication is this is a loose body, post-traumatic contour injuries. Loose body can seem to be, which was seen through an MRI. You are visualizing through a 3-4 portal, and that's the contour lesion which you can see on the lunate. And this is a loose body which is all along. This is the contour lesion. You can see it on the lunate. And this is the loose body which is really mobile, then that has to be removed. This was, you can take it out to a 6R portal. There's another entity which was Dr. Ravi was showing you on the MRI, ulnar impaction syndrome, ulnar impaction. You're visualizing in this situation, you're seeing from a 3-4 portal. It's got a, again, central tear here. Ulna is seen. Basically, this happens on a pronated and dorsiflex hand. And you see a dorsal rim also. There is a dorsal rim tear, and this is a softening of the contour malacia, which you can see on the lunate, and that's the dorsal capsular tear of the TFCC. So all you may not be able to repair the central tear, but the dorsal capsular tear is amenable to repair. This is another rare case, although a rare entity. This is called as a ulnar impingement or ulnar styloid impingement. Even though you can see the ulnar negative ulnar variance, but you can see the prominent ulnar styloid there, and the MRI shows a lot of indentation on the trichoderm. You can see much of cystic lesions, changes, repeated injury. This is because it's been for more than more than 2 years, so the multiple cystic changes you can see. It's quite useful, and you have irreparable tear. Even though arthroscopic MRI showed there is a tear, but here when we went, we wanted to repair it. When you saw that it's a massive tear which was not amenable to repair, and you can also see a lot of chondral lesions on the. You can see these are the chondral lesions which are on the trichoderm as well as the lunate. These are quite big chondral lesions, so you can do multiple arthroscopic drilling for this thing so that it bleeds and the fibrocartilage is formed on this part. See this? These are the chondral lesions there. In this situation, you could remove the prominent ulnar styloid by burr. So SL ligament. So when you're visualizing, when you want to assess for a scapholunate ligament, this is a view through the 3-4 portal. You can see normally it shows as a concave interval there. That is how the SL ligament normally sees through a 3-4 portal. You can also assess through a MCU, which is much better, MCR or MCU portal. And that is the ideal way to pick up this thing. This is how a normal, you are visualizing from 3-4 portal and you are trying to probe for a 3-4 interval. It's quite, the SL interval. Basically, you visualize through MCU and you palpate for this through an MCR portal. You can see that's tight. You could not move the gap could not be bent. That was the thing. A partial injury is quite difficult to assess unless you probe them. So when you check like this, it will be, you have to rock it. Once you rock the palpate, the scaphoid tuberosity and try to open it, you can see the gap is opening up. So that shows the partial injury of the SL injury, because normally when you just visualize, you can see that it's quite, there's hardly any space between these two. But when you try to rock it, you can see that's opening up of the scapholunate interval. These are quite amenable or quite easy to repair arthroscopically as well. A complete injury would look something like this. There are various grades for it. So this is a complete tear of the SL injury. You are seeing through this. And when you can try to rock the scaphoid as well and try to drive through your scope as well. If it goes through, that means it's a complete scapholunate ligament injury when you're viewing through a MCR portal here. Next, the other essential thing which you want to know when you want to identify for a lunotrichoderm ligament injury is, you should remember there should be normally a lunotrichoderm injury on an X-ray shows as a step in this, but you should also remember there are type 2 lunates which are usually appear as a vigas type 2, where there is normally a step but the interval is quite tight. So you're visualizing through MCU portal and the step between L2 should not, LT should not be, you can see this is a step, but whereas you can see the facet also here. This is for the articular part for the hammet. So this is a type 2 lunate. So this is not a tone LT, but whereas a normal variant of the LT interval. So how do you assess? So again, same LT, you need to probe, and ballotment is of the LT interval is quite useful when you're assessing for a LT ligament. So that's, you're viewing through the MCU portal. That's the LT interval which has been injured. You can palpate well. You can see that you can push your probe all through. That's almost 2 months old injury. And you can see you can push that, you can rock the trichoderm there. And also you can rock it from externally, just like a shock test, what was described there. So you can see those LT interval was quite severe. You mean that this is a complete LT injury. This needs to be repaired. The other things are the volar ganglion and dorsal ganglion. So this I'll be speaking in a real life video again. But however, you can see some of these dorsal, when you're trying to, this is a dorsal ganglion excision. How does it look? So basically you view through either 1-2 portal or 6R portal. This, now we are viewing from a 1-2 portal and the instrument is through the 6R portal. That's how it looks like. That's a bluish cyst which you can see on the dorsal capsular reflection. This is basically, this reflection is between the midcarpal and the radiocarpal joint. So I am working through the radiocarpal joint and trying to take off those ganglion cysts. So another point, and when you are taking up the trowel, it can be multiple septations can be there, so that you need to, MRI is quite critical when you are doing arthroscopic ganglion excision, because these are the ones which are painful ganglions are the only ones which you try to. So there are multiple cysts which you, there is a likely possibility if you don't do a MRI, you can miss it, you can remove one of the cysts and assume that. So you need to puncture them and you need to assess, feel well up to the ligament part where these multiple septations are being removed in this dorsal ganglion. And that's the entire part of the cap, 1 centimeter capsule removed. So this is the volar ganglion. Ganglions, it's nice to do on a dry scopy, especially at the volar ganglion one. So you are seeing the first you establish a 3-4 portal, next the 6R portal you need to check. So, but whereas dorsal ganglions, it's difficult to see through, do a dry arthroscopy, whereas in volar ganglions, it's easy to do. So now the cyst is open there as soon as it started working through the radio, shortened radio, long radiolunate ligaments. And this is a scaphoid. The next condition is a scaphoid non-union. So you are basically identifying the scaphoid non-union. You're visualizing through a MCU portal, MCR portal, and your probe is through the STTU portal. This is another accessory portal which is created to identify the, or work through the scaphoid non-union site, which is along the radial border of the index metacarpal and just proximal to the MCR portal. So that you need to prepare that. So once you probe them, you need to use a shaver as well as a burr and cure it. So you freshen the non-union site here. That's a non-union site which you're visualizing there. So you've been using the curette as well. And once you can take a, this is exactly the this is the distal pole and this is the proximal pole of the non-union site. And you're seeing the radiocarpal joint through this interval of the non-union site as well. Coming to one of the last, this thing, Kienbock disease. This is one of the modification or Lichman's modification by Bain, which he presented. So somehow he has documented that the proximal part of the lunate as the first one to show arthroscopic changes. So you do an arthroscopic wrist arthroscopy, and then you can decide as well what procedure is ideal. For example, in this situation, you can see that's the, you are visualizing the mid-carpal portal. You can see the, that's the capitate, the cartilage is worn out there. This is a completely damaged lunate, and the gap is so extensive. This is the lunate, and this is the interval. This is a cartilage loss. So basically, this is an advanced stage. So probably something in this stage, even the lunate is, even the capitate is injured. So you can plan. In this case, we did a, you can do a partial carpal fusion. That would be one of the options in this case, because even the capitate is partly injured. So these are the various, means this is a bird's view of what are the possibilities which can be done. So this is what was the classification which I was mentioning. But it's in Kienbock, I think it's useful if you are likely to complete the entire procedure arthroscopically, or else just do a diagnostic arthroscopy. It doesn't serve much purpose because a lot of information is given on the MRI itself, other than few changes in the cartilage. So the list is huge, so it has kindled some interest. Maybe you will be seeing some of procedures after this. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Doshanjan, to take us through with such an extensive area and picking